possibly in the entire CA fraternity, we would be the first firm who will tell in the appointment letter, which is a contract of employment, 11 o'clock 10 minutes to 11 o'clock 20 minutes, there is an infini minute. You would need to observe this infini minute. What would happen in such circumstances is, creating an ethos for the organization is one. Creating and implementing the ethos in another thing. The joy of the infini minute is at Guru Anjana, where automatically a bill goes up at 11 o'clock 10 and the entire entity stops, gravitates, accumulates, merges, moves, evolves itself and dissolves in the minute. And exactly at 11 o'clock 12 minutes, the office starts with a new vigor. Think, 10:30 is such time for all. As I stopped my vision speech yesterday at 10:15, at 11 o'clock 10 minutes, I told you, those 2 minutes are precious. Think about your Lord. Think about your Krishna. Think about your Father. Pray for the world. But whatever you do, pray that 2 minutes. It makes all the difference. And as Mahatreya talks, it is good that you can get your entire family together. It is good that you get the team together. I have told my family is seeing the infini path, or some of my mind always tells when Mahatreya talks, it is either infini path or HTV. My family down would be seeing the entire event. The entire event would go there down and they would all be seeing. As the minute happens, everybody would be there. If one sentence could create a vision, if one sentence could ensure that 400 people would get salaries on time, if one sentence is going to tell that there are going to be enough to do in the next 10 years, imagine what 45 minutes could do. Imagine what a narrative of the Mahatreya in the next 30 minutes would do. So be with me.
Life is beautiful. Life is truly beautiful. Happy morning, and loving you all so much. I want to share a few very personal incidents from my life before I start doing justice to all of you and to the occasion. Most of the people who have been associated with me for a long period of time know these incidences, but just to put the entire celebration into context, I want to speak about them. The first incident I want to speak is, it happened when I was 19. I was in my first job. I used to teach computer programming in Pune. Weaknesses and expressions of a 19-year-old. There was a very beautiful girl in the class, and I wanted to exploit the advantage of being a teacher and touch her once. Now don't look at each other. Now I'm a good man. Okay, this happened when I was 19. And I used this context that I was the teacher to go close to her and just held her hand and lifted it and asked her, what are you writing? Knowing very well, I know what she was writing because she was only reproducing whatever I had already written on the board. But this was just an excuse for me to touch her. As Providence would have it, my branch manager, by name Peter Christian, was right there at the door of the classroom. And in a typical British style, he said, in my room right now. And he walked. He had no business to come to my classroom. I think senior management should remain in their room, but he didn't. So I went behind him to his room. And the next 10 feet I would have walked in my mind, I would have thought thousands of excuses to defend myself. And the moment I entered his cabin, the first sentence he said was, I have no right to tell you what to do and what not to do. You can't fight with a guy who is not ready for a fight. Now this man was not ready for a fight. He started the whole conversation by saying, I have no right to tell you what you can do and what you cannot do. But I have a right to tell you this. If you cannot have a spotless character, do not be a teacher in life. Because when a teacher has a character blemish, they will not tell you, you faltered. They would say, all teachers are like that. So don't bring disgrace to the entire teaching fraternity. Whatever he was saying made sense, but I was wanting to justify myself and I wanted to make it look like I was not wrong. Easier to understand all these things, if you remember, again and again, I was 19. So in order to justify, I told him, but you'll have to understand, I'm just 19. Before I could speak any other sentence, he told me in return, that's a very important decision that you will have to make. Do you want to be a typical 19-year-old? Or do you want to be a 19-year-old where all other 19-year-olds will look up to you? I couldn't speak another word to him. I didn't have to speak another word. I knew in that moment my life had changed. The reason I'm sharing this with you right in the beginning is the fascination of being a human being is when the mind of the man is transformed, man is transformed. Till this morning, my thought patterns, my outlook towards life, my attitude towards life could have been anything. And it's not necessarily in what Matri is sharing with you. It can be in observing a colleague. It can be listening to somebody else. It can be an inspiration that you not necessarily derive from the senior management or from the partners. It can be the way a junior, a new joiner who has just joined a few weeks ago, the way they carry about their work, the way a gardener works in the garden. Any observation can simply change the way we think, and that can change our life. Certain speeches are born out of certain lives. Certain lives are born out of certain speeches. Today I'm going around all the time teaching the world to change them. But my life changed that day with just these two sentences. That's an important choice you will have to make. Do you want to be a typical 19-year-old or do you want to be a 19-year-old where all the other 19-year-olds look up to you? Even today, that is the only benchmark on which I live my life. Are you another 55-year-old or are you a 55-year-old where all the other 55-year-olds can look up to you? Are you just another teacher? Or are you a teacher where the entire fraternity of teachers can look up to you? Are you just another husband? Are you just another father? Are you just another citizen? Am I just one more chartered accountant? Or can I be a chartered accountant where chartered accountants look up to me for inspiration? Am I just another chartered accountancy firm? Out of 10 chartered accountants, 7 of them start their own practice after 3 to 5 years. Begging for business, craving for business, hoping for the payment to come. Am I just another chartered accountancy firm, or can I be a chartered accountancy firm where the other chartered accountancy firms look up to me? And that's what brings us to this moment of celebration. To set a goal that I will be in the top 20 by 2020 and to reach there. I've received 4 emails from other chartered accountancy firms about Guru Jana today. 4 other people. Saying that now they are setting a goal by 2030, they will be in the top 30. And I think to know that you have been an inspiration for others to aspire, and this is the most incredible thing about being a human being, that I can change the way I think and that will change my life. In my second job, I was working for a company called Usha Computers. And a very complex problem in computerization of Bank of India had to be resolved, open office. We had to offer them an answer in 2 hours' time. None of us had a solution. And it was very tense. Everybody was tense. Everybody was arguing. Everybody was blaming each other. Everybody was raising their voice. There was pandemonium there. And suddenly, the AGM, by name David Sampson, stood up and just screamed, "There is a way." And there was hush in the entire organization. Because we were trying to solve something technically. David Sampson is a marketing guy. He knows nothing about programming or coding or technicalities of technology. He knows to sell. And we're trying to solve a technical problem. And here a marketing guy stands up there and screams. He was the senior most guy. He was heading the branch. And he screamed, "There is a way." And the moment we heard "there is a way," all the noise settled down there. All the heads turned towards David Sampson. We were all only looking at him. And he smiled and said, "The way is on the way. I don't have the way yet, but I can tell you there is a way, and the way is on the way." And before we took it as a joke, he clarified by saying, the next thought, or the 10th thought, or the 20th thought, the nth thought is a solution. We have to only keep thinking till we hit the solution. If one thought became the question, another thought will become the answer. Just because right now I don't have an answer doesn't mean I won't have an answer. Keep thinking. The 10th thought, or the 20th thought, or the nth thought will become the answer. Just the perspective he gave. And I was 20. For the last 35 years, I've lived my life believing there is no problem without a solution. There's no question without an answer. There is no situation that cannot be turned into an opportunity. Even when pandemic is going on, even when lockdown is going on, everybody is saying, I'm still saying that there are revolutionary possibilities for us to discover this moment. Because I remember last time when I had come for a college inauguration in Bengaluru. And as the car was going by, Mohini, Arun, 2 people, you may know, you may not know, me and Gopal, we were there in the car. And it was going through, one of them said, "This is Guru Jana's office." And even without thinking, I casually told them, "It's my desire that I want to practice infinite minute there one of these days. But I think I'll make it a surprise. I'll suddenly land up in that building one day." And then things have changed. The world has changed. And today it's happening. Okay. In a different form. I'm not physically there, but in a different form. So it's fascinating to know that the nth thought in a human being can be a breakthrough. The nth thought in a human being can be innovation. The nth thought in a human being can be 100 crore business model. The next idea can not only transform your life, might transform the entire country, can transform your entire industry. And just referring to these two incidents brings me the context to interact with you today, because it's not about speeches. I think we listen to a lot of speeches. We live in a social media world. There's too much content that is available. Are you ready to change your mind? Getting transfixed to what I believe in. Yesterday I was telling my son, we have to appreciate people who are ready to change their beliefs in the context of new knowledge. In a world which is so fixed, full of fixation, this is how we do it, this is how we are, this is how we have always done. Even in Gurujana, that can be the language. Because a lot of things have worked for us, sometimes good can become the enemy of the best by saying that this is how we always do. And yet it's fascinating to relate with human being where, for all the success that they have achieved, for where they sit in an organization, if you are ready to shift the way you operate, if you are ready to shift into best practices, if you are ready to shift your beliefs in the context of new knowledge, that means you as an individual is not transfixed but continuously transcendental in nature, which is what makes being a human being such a blessing, because we are an evolving consciousness. So what I want to share with you in the next 15 minutes is in this belief that if I was in front of you, I would have called you sweethearts. I don't know why, but I love that word. Becoming a chartered accountant is just the beginning. And life is like this. You set a goal and you achieve the goal to realize every finishing line is the new starting line. Now from there, the whole journey begins again. Now where do I go? Okay, you become a partner. Once again, that is the new starting line. How do you become the most contributive partner? How do I ensure that as a partner, the ROI I bring into the business is greater than anybody else in the organization? How do I ensure that I am the greatest contributor within an organization? It's again, we have reached top 20. After the celebration gets over today, tomorrow, we are again at the starting line towards the next goal. Life is a series of new beginnings. Every finishing line is the new starting line. Just that now, right now, you are in a much better maturity. But the challenge is to build success on success. When you had nothing, anything you did was successful. When you are already Gurujana, when you are already a partner in Gurujana, when you are already a chartered accountant in Gurujana, a sense of I have arrived can get into our head. And from there to tell yourself, I'm still in the starting block. And from there to begin this entire thing. So I'm going to share with you a research that has been done. From here onwards, there's nothing common. There's only you and me. I don't know how many of you are sitting there, but it's just you and me. Just for the next few minutes, forget everybody in front of you, beside you, behind you, and just stay with me. Hopefully, like my life changed that day when I decided in whatever I do, I will be the one who is looked up to and not another one in the crowd. Just the way that moment my life changed, there is a way, and the way is on the way. The nth thought will solve everything that we are going through right now. You have to keep thinking till you hit upon the nth thought. Let today be your transformation. Maybe it already is. Because if I have just understood every finishing line is the new starting line, the josh with which you live your life, then you know that life is a continuous discovery. It's a journey. It's an exploration. It's not about milestones. It's not about results. It's not about goals. It's about the journey of discovering yourself in the process to know that you can live out of a higher maturity than the maturity you already have. You can upgrade your competence for it to become much better than what it already is. You can leverage technology far better than how you've already done. Your leadership skills, your relationship skills, your negotiation skills can go several levels better than what it already is. You can be a lot happier at work than you are right now. You can shed your sense of judgment or gossip or lying or cynicism. Drop a lot of negative, and you know that every sunrise, by virtue of being a human being, I can keep discovering a new version of myself. Make this whole journey of life with every breath to the last breath worth it. Absolutely worth it. So a research was done where they analyzed the 500 most successful people in the world, and they took a sample from everything, right from spiritual reformers like Jesus Christ or Prophet, social reformers like Martin Luther King, Nelson Mandela, Mahatma Gandhi, celebrities like Clint Eastwood, painters, artists like Picasso, Leonardo da Vinci, entertainers, sports people. In fact, they had an absolute cross section, industrialists like Henry Ford. They took an entire cross section of the world of 500 most successful people. And this research was done much before the Elon Musk's and the Bezos had come. It was done a long time back. And they found out there were 7 attributes which was common to all the 500 people. I truly hope that whatever I share does not just enhance your memory, but enables each one of you to find out which of these you need to work upon. I'm listing the 7 not for you to pat yourself on the back saying that I already have 3, then the remaining 4 is your scope of transformation. I already have 6, then the 7th one is the scope for your transformation. I already have all the 7. More down to you. The first thing that was common in the 500 most successful people in the world was passion. Passion. They were never seen tired. They were never seen disinterested. There was always this excitement that they didn't want to be the crowd. They always wanted to be the benchmark. In whatever they did, they wanted to leave a mark. Not be an also-ran. Not I am also a chartered accountant, or I am also a citizen, or I also work in this organization. They didn't want to be employee numbers in the payroll. They wanted a name, and they wanted a name that had to sound across the board in the organization. In whatever they did, didn't matter whether they were cutting vegetables, didn't matter whether they were painting or acting, they had set certain standards and they wanted to hold on to that standards all the time in whatever they did. Essentially, they wanted to make their life count. They wanted to make their potential count. They always tried to be the best in whatever they did. Passion. Unfortunately, this cannot be transferred from outside. It has to come from within. You can have the best of the HR practices. You can create the greatest work environment. But passion cannot be transferred from outside. This is one thing that is there or it's not there. It has to come from inside. And I think it comes by finding out what excites you the most. There is this phrase called Swadharma. Essentially, let's not go into too much of complication here. Simply understood, doing what you feel more energetic is your Swadharma. Doing what you become tired is not. Maybe there is a chartered accountant here who has to become a celebrated singer. Don't want to let any one of you do this, but let me be true to the speech. And maybe you're meant to be a singer. And that's where your passion is. You became a chartered accountant for your parents' sake. And right now numbers are not talking to you. But for one of you, your deepest meditation is numbers. If numbers are in front of you, you can chant numbers also. In fact, spreadsheets talk to you. Even when you are sleeping, calculations are going on. Financial strategies are going on. Having become a chartered accountant for one of you within this, taxation might be a passion. Teaching might be a passion. Technology might be a passion. Finance management might be a passion. Investment might be a passion. So within this, you learn to find out what gives you a kick. What makes you feel, look forward to every minute of your life? Passion. Two, methodology. Everybody had their own unique style. The worst thing that can happen to Guru Jana is everybody trying to copy the style of Guru Prasad Makam. That's the worst thing that can happen. The best thing that can happen to Guru Jana is that it has hundreds of unique, original styles of working. That's the best thing. Culturally integrated, in our value system we are integrated, but we are not trying to ape anybody else. You can't be anybody else. You will only be a second grade anybody else if you try to ape anybody else. Sri has her style, Vijay Raja has his style, and each one has to take, KL has his style. Everybody has to follow your own style. Everybody has to discover your own methodology, what works for you. We cannot be anybody else. Just because Maitreya speaks with so much intensity, a hand movement, you try to speak like that, people say, why are you shouting? Suits me, it won't suit. For one of you, probably only a very sattvic, passive style of communication will work. Smile suits somebody. Some of you don't smile. I don't smile. I can't smile. And when I smile, I look very artificial. Oh, they are all smiling. I will also smile. I look plastic. For me, being intense is who I am. And that's how I want to be. You have to discover your methodology. You have to find your style. All of them had their own ways of doing whatever they did. Steve Jobs cannot be Bill Gates. Bill Gates cannot be Jeff Bezos. You cannot be anybody else. You have to find what works for you. Trump can get away however he speaks. Not everybody can get away. Simplicity worked with Abdul Kalam, but it won't work for everybody. You'll have to find out what is your methodology. Three, mastery in communication. You will already discover, even if you're a national rank holder in chartered accountancy, from here onwards, if you don't know how to communicate, you'll be left behind. Presentation of a balance sheet is more important than preparing a balance sheet. Presentation of your future projections is what will determine whether you can get an investor or you will not get an investor. Communication is the dividing line in negotiation. 2% that side or 2% this side is all about communication. You can be the most loving husband, but if you don't know to talk, you cannot have a great marriage. Your children can be the purpose of your life, but if you don't know to communicate, you cannot be a good parent. I can have the greatest wisdom in the world, but if I don't know how to talk, nobody, including me, will listen to me. Communication. Even if you are Jesus Christ, the world will know you only if you know to communicate. We have given more credit to Mahatma Gandhi for Indian freedom than anybody else. in spite of the fact a lot of people have done a lot. But Mahatma Gandhi was a better communicator than Subhash Chandra Bose. That's the only difference. And somehow, whether you consider it fair or not, the world gets drawn towards communicator. Leadership is about communication. Mastery in communication. So as fascinated as you might be about how you are good at numbers or analytical skills, you will have to be a willing communicator. Today, an individual is a brand in the world. It's no more just about Tatas. Ratan Tata has to be a brand. It's no more about Infosys. Narayana Murthy has to be a brand. Vikas Shikhar took over. He couldn't make himself a brand. He didn't fit into Infosys. Narendra Modi has to be a brand. Your own young, enterprising MP from Bangalore is MP from Bangalore because of his strength of mastery in communication. Parliament wants to listen to him when he speaks because he knows to present ideas. So make yourself a willing communicator and develop yourself. Four, the ability to build a team around them. The ability to build a team around them. Nobody makes it alone. You became a chartered accountant alone, but you will become a successful chartered accountant leader or successful management consultant, successful investment advisor based on the strength of relationships within the organization, across the industry, with your clients, with bankers. It's all about networking. It's all about relationships. It's all about winning enough people to your cause. If some of you sitting here with all your capabilities still feel why I'm not getting the recognition I should be getting, you're not having enough meaningful relationship within the organization. End of the day, all parameters same. Whether you will get the business from the Fortune 500 company or not, now depends on how you communicate. A lot of people have moved from the Big Four towards Guru Jana, not just because of your technical abilities alone. It's because of how you relate with your customers and clients. And that makes a lot of difference. The word partner cannot be a terminology. We have to actually feel that in the quality of relationship that we share. Five, energy levels. Enthusiasm was their middle name. Anything they did, there was enthusiasm and intensity to it. There was never a dull moment. There are no off days in the life of a legend. In the next 3 years, next 5 years, next 10 years, you want your life to grow to some legendary proportions? Even within the partners, even within the organization, which are the people you want to go and talk to? Any one of them who is contagious with enthusiasm and intensity, you want to run towards them. Any one of them where there is always the sense of fatigue, tiredness, lethargy, even in the voice, you repel them. All of them. Even if they represented religion, even if they represented social transformation, the central attribute of all these people is enthusiasm and intensity. Just to ensure, because in your mind you'll be trying to recall, do I remember all the five? Passion. Anyway, this is getting recorded, so you can see it again. Passion. Methodology. Mastery in communication. Ability to build a team. High energy levels, faith. Their confidence came from something above them, beyond them. It need not be God. Thomas Alva Edison, to any of the atheists who is already looking this side, that side, Thomas Alva Edison by the traditional word was an atheist, but his faith was science. He never believed science will let him down. For a Dhirubhai Ambani, his faith was his mother's blessings. Why all this? In the last board meeting, Mukesh Ambani, after making the entire presentation, concludes the entire AGM by saying, and all this would not have been possible but for my faith in my Krishna. Albert Einstein was anchored on faith. I don't think any one of us are more intelligent than these people. And if they all anchored their life to faith, there must be some science to it. It need not be God, but it has to be something. This entire arrogance and ego of I, me, myself, and everything, I can do it, has caused more people to fall in life than to rise in life. In fact, the feeling of I is a burden. You get liberated from this by seeing yourself as an instrument of anything. An instrument of an higher force, an instrument of this fascinating field of finance, accounts. Just think about it. For several decades, this field of finance and accounts and technology has evolved on the pedestal of which our life is made. The sheer, if I were you, I'll see myself as an instrument of this industry. I would believe that numbers chose me to be its instrument. So they were all anchored on faith. Even Jesus Christ, who is worshipped as God, still uttered his daily prayer, "Thank you, God, for my daily bread." Even a Buddha, who is worshipped as God, sat in the seat of meditation on a daily basis to connect to a higher energy. Even a prophet prayed 5 times a day. Even a Mahatma Gandhi, Mahatma, and yet he said, "There's nothing that I've achieved that my 200 million brethren cannot achieve." That time that was the population in India. "There's nothing that I've achieved that my 200 million brethren cannot achieve, provided they also find the spiritual alignment that I have found." They were all anchored to a higher force, enabling that higher energy to express itself through them. And 7, value-based living. Their decisions and choices were not based on emotions. They had an integrity towards their values and principles. They had a decision-making framework. And they operated within this decision-making framework. "Need be, I'll give my life, but I shall not take a life," was a value Gandhi lived by. "I shall always be the citizen of this country, but not a member of any religion," Abdul Kalam always lived by. "In every breath I will ask, what I can do for my country and not what my country has done for me." To the very last breath, Kennedy was able to live by that. They had very, very strong value system. Entitlement and inheritance will not be part of Infosys. The 5 of them formulated Infosys like that, and they lived up to it till the end. They did not pass it on to their own children. Entitlement and inheritance will not be part of Infosys. They lived up to it. Legal or not, I don't care. If it's not ethical, we shall not do it. Jayadi Tata lived up to it to the very end. Legal or not, I don't care. Ethical or not matters to me. If it is not ethical, I will not do it. And Jayadi was able to live up to it to the end. "At any given time, what I give will be greater than what I have consumed." Our own Azim Premji from Karnataka has lives up to it even today, ensuring what he is doing is much, much greater to society than what he kept. value-based living. And that is what it's going to do. So identify within these seven, what is that one thing you're going to immediately focus on and conquer it by December 31st? We have 5 months left. And one at a time, if you can ensure that all these seven attributes are part of you, trust me, you're on your way to greatness. Passion, methodology, mastery in communication, ability to build a team, high energy levels, faith, value-based decision-making and choices, and not mood-based, emotion-based. I'm a big believer of silence. My faith is my silence. I am everything, and everybody who is connected to me, I believe in whatever way Matriya's womb of silence has protected them. It's all been because of silence. My faith is my silence. And I share this silence. Not only to brand Gurujana as a whole, and to all the partners here, where most of them are no different from Ashruta, Radhya or Shubha for me. They are as good as my own children. But I'm sharing with all of you whom I'm not seeing right now. You're not here to be another 19-year-old. You're here to be a 19-year-old where all the other 19-year-olds can look up to you. You're not here to be another professional. You're here to be an inspirational role model for everybody else. Make your parents proud. Make your profession proud. And make your God proud in the way you live your life. Let's practice infinite minute. And today's infinite minute is exclusively for Gurujana. wishing you all a future infinitely more humongous than your entire past. I repeat, make your parents proud, make your profession proud of having you, and let your God always feel proud loving you all so much. Thank you. And my love to all the adorable families that have suddenly appeared. Love you guys. Love you so much.